What up, y'all? It's Kid Forward, Fate, and Big Boss Fable, man. I'm back with a video for the channel, man. I'm back with a reaction to Andrew Tate, man. If you don't know who Andrew Tate is, you probably don't know because he got canceled or you've been living under a rock when he went through his whole virality. But this is Andrew Tate, will change your life in 2 minutes. And a lot of people, you know, basically he's like a male inspirational figure, right? He kind of gives the caveats. He kind of just gives, you know, pretty much the guideline to, you know, becoming your best self, becoming, you know, wealthy, financially wealthy, successful, and kind of the approach in the male and female dynamic. Now, a lot of what he said has been controversial, right? That's why he's got canceled in the first place. They removed his Instagram. They took away his Twitter. I think he's back on Twitter now, man. Shout out Elon Musk. But they took down his YouTube. They just try to just remove him because Buddy say some outlandish stuff. And it's really more so the male and female dynamic to what he's talking about. And honestly, I don't think what he's saying is really detrimental. It's just that we live in a society that's very soft. We live in a society that, you know, gets their feelings hurt too easy. And that's why he canceled in the first place. If not, he was, at that point in time, he was the number one most searched person on the internet. Like, he had the most searches on Google. Anytime you put his name in with something, it would go viral. Or they would try to cancel you. They'll try to turn it off. But he just says a lot of controversial things as if it's just things that people aren't used to hearing. You know what I'm saying? It's not like people don't think these things every day. So, or some people do. I'm not going to say. He is an extremist. You know what I'm saying? So that kind of adds to the flair. But Andrew Tate, I guess he's on Wise Mentality talking about, you know, some things here. But let me know y'all's thoughts on this one in the comment section below. If you have any feedback regarding Andrew Tate, I'm sure I'm going to get everybody, "Oh my God, you did a reaction to the misogynist." Yeah. You know, people going to be complaining about, "Oh my God, you reacted to Andrew Tate." Who cares, bro? Like, Andrew Tate is Andrew Tate. He's him. I'm I. But, you know, there's some insight into this, and he do be dropping gems, man. It's not like he's just a clown. It's not like he made himself a multimillionaire just by being a lazy bum. He's a hard worker. He's a very intellectual individual. So without further ado, I'm going to hop right into this reaction, man. Let me know some of your thoughts, some of your ideas, man. With that being said, man, check out everything I got going on in the description down below. Let's get it.
You lose.
Andrew Tate will change your life in 2 minutes, bruh. Do you think he can do it? Ready, set.
Chess teaches you that if you lose, at some point you made a mistake. It doesn't matter if it's the smallest mistake. It doesn't matter if you just took too long to think to make the right move and you ran out of time on the clock. At some point, you fucked up for you to lose that game. It's 100% accountability with no luck. That's what's so important about learning chess. That's the first thing. And the second thing is, you need to, as a man, adopt the mindset that absolutely everything that happens to you is completely and utterly your fault, whether it's good or bad. And most men don't have that. Most men don't have that. When the Matrix was
Facts. And I would say a lot of, you know, I think people in general need to learn how to take accountability because a lot of folks don't do that. They blame this. And, oh, it's my, I was sick that day. Oh, I was tired that day. Oh, I was sad that day. Oh, it's my depression. Like, everything in life is mental, in my opinion, bro. You just got to excel. You got to be disciplined, mentally tough. It's really discipline, bro. It's really discipline. If you mentally tough, you can really get through anything. Of course, it's going to hurt. Of course, it's going to be, you know, maybe anxious, nerve-wracking, XYZ, whatever it may be. But learn to have accountability for certain things, man. Don't, because when you don't have accountability, you're going to blame everything else in life. And at that point in time, you know, you don't take ownership for anything. So whose fault is it really? Like, you know what I'm saying? If you fail a test, you fail the test because you didn't study, because you weren't prepped for it. You know, the same thing applies to different situations in life, in my opinion. Kind of let me know y'all's thoughts on that one in the comments.
Attacking me and they were destroying me. When they're calling up my exes trying to get fake fucking charges on me and put me in jail. When they close my bank accounts and I use $10, $11 million. When they ban me on all across all social medias and lie about me. When they harass my family. When I'm sitting there going, this is my fault. All of this is me. I got here. It's my fault. I'm not going, that was unfair. It was orchestrated. The NGOs worked against me. Because that is not helpful.
So it's accountability.
It's 100% accountability in all things. But also when I go out there and I start the Bugatti, it's like, that's me.
He said, and I start the Bugatti. This fool crazy. But one thing he did say, I'm kind of surprised that he was saying that him getting canceled is him. I mean, taking accountability, you can say things and people will perceive it a certain way. So to an extent, I don't know if it's really you. Like, you could be the sweetest guy in the world, the nicest dude, and somebody be like, man, I hate that kid. So what are you taking ownership for there? What are you taking ownership for in that situation? If you're a good person, or you a sweet kid, and then there's one dickhead, oh man, I don't like this kid, man, he's too sweet. You're too nice. So you're going to take accountability for being too nice? I could have been meaner. There's a fine line between it. You know what I'm saying? Because some people are just ridiculous. They're going to pass judgment. They're going to have a certain perception of you regardless, no matter what you do, bro.
This is my fault. The car is my fault, and the big house is my fault, and everything that ever goes wrong
is
my fault.
Successes and
failures. Yeah, absolutely. You have to take complete and utter accountability for everything. You can't make excuses ever. Yeah. There's never an excuse. And you're right. People try and put things on the outwards, on the outside. It's interesting. I remember watching Forrest Gump about 5 years ago. I was on a plane. I can't remember where I was flying. And the beginning of Forrest Gump has a scene in it, which I don't think many people actually have ever analyzed or anticipated or understood what the scene means. But when he's sitting on the bench at the beginning, think about Forrest Gump. He's sitting on the bench at the beginning and there's a feather blowing.
Yeah, he nailed this.
Yeah, yeah.
And then it lands on him and the movie begins.
Yeah.
What they're saying with that is Forrest is the feather and life has just pushed him all over and put him in all these unusual scenarios. Life has directed him everywhere. Yeah. That's what it's saying.
Sure.
And if you're going to be the guy and you're going to allow life to happen to you and you're not going to happen to life, then you're at mercy of the wind.
Whoa. We got to take that back for some slow folks. He said, if you're going to allow life to happen to you versus happening in... What he say?
You're going to allow life to happen to you and you're not going to happen to life.
Allow life to happen to you, but you don't happen to life. Bruh, that was deep. Damn.
Life, then you're at mercy of the wind. Perhaps it might work out okay, but it might not, right? So you have to be the guy who goes, okay, the wind's blowing in this direction. Fuck them. I'm doing this. You have to come to life. You can't let life come to you, because if you let life come to you, then you're going to be living inside of a matrix and a system which is designed not for you to live your best life. It's designed for you to comply.
That's a
help
fact,
your teen
bro.
Have a more positive that's online experience with Instagram.
Buddy hit it right on the head, man. I mean, you just a follower at that point, you know what I'm saying? Like, sheesh. That right there, man, is Andrew Tate will change your life in 2 minutes. Now, he dropped a lot of gems in that short span of time, and that's what I've been trying to say to you guys about Andrew Tate. He's giving gems out. He's really propelling himself in the atmosphere of self-improvement and, you know, male development. A lot of these men out here weak, soft, and I think they can learn a lot from Andrew Tate's perspective. Not to say that, you know, everything he says is accurate or correct, but a lot of what he says got some truth to it. And, you know, when it comes to anybody's advice, take what you can, leave what you can't. You know what I'm saying? Take what is actually applicable. So I think Andrew Tate does a very good job of really, you know, relating to the average Joe. Because not everybody is living a multi-million-dollar lifestyle riding around the Bugattis. He talks about the struggles, how to get there. He talks about how to maintain it and pretty much, you know, kind of how to separate yourself from the pack, man. You got to be different out here in 2023. It's funny, I always be saying 2023, like January already here. But nah, bro, we in 2023 already. Feel me? Like, yo. Hey, but that's Andrew Tate will change your life in 2 minutes. Let me know y'all's thoughts on this one in the comment section below. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Shout out Wise Mentality for dropping this one. Yeah, just go check out his stuff. Check out his content, man. I got introduced to him through Fresh and Fit. A lot of people don't like them neither. But, I mean, if it's male self-improvement and you're talking about ways to get your credit up, get your money up, I'm going to tune in, bro. I'm going to tune in because I'm always trying to develop and better myself. With that being said, like, comment, subscribe, hit notification bell. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter for Famous Road of Men. Subscribe, man. Peace, love, prosperity, everybody rocking with the channel. Go ahead and check out what I got going on in the description down below, man. Donations are open on the channel. If you have specific recommendations, go ahead and donate. Support a young entrepreneur. Go ahead and donate, man. My PayPal link is open, man. Peace. Appreciate the love. Appreciate the requests. We'll catch you guys in the next video. We out.